kettlebell cleans can get downright ugly. Some of the stuff I've seen on the internet is horrible. And I think people just need to break it down a little bit more. So here's a three-step process to learn to keep the kettlebell in close and avoid all the banging of the wrist. So I'm gonna start with a dead clean. So we're cleaning up. The bell's between our legs, and we're just gonna clean up into the rack position. We're still using our hips in this position. So we're sitting back into our hinge, up, and catching the rack position. Goal here is to let the legs do the work and catch softly. And in this rack position, we're tight. So abs are tight, glutes are squeezed, quads are tight. Once you've worked through that and you got the bell landing softly on both the left and right side, the next step is to move in front of the kettlebell. So the kettlebell is behind your heels. So we're reaching back more and coming up and getting it to land softly. Come back down, bring it back to a dead stop, feet into the floor, and catching into this tight glutes, abs, and quads position. Again, work on this until you have it down on both sides where it's landing softly and the legs are doing the work for you. You don't want to be jerking the arm because we want to use the clean to prepare us for something else rather than use it to build up arm strength. Then, last position, so we've moved from here to here. Now, third position, it's the bottom of our swing, the bottom of our clean. So the bell's higher, and it's just that same motion. So we'll clean up and start the rack position. We're gonna throw the bell down and back and catch in the rack position. Down and back and catch in the rack position. So if you find that the bell is slapping your wrist or common issue, bell's way out here and your arm's getting away from your body rather than drawing up in front, it's a great three-step process to help fix your clean. Let me know how it works out for you.